Hello students, welcome for today's video lecture of maths. Today, in today's lecture, we are going to learn the conversion of rational numbers into decimals. In yesterday's lecture, you have seen how to find the rational numbers between two rational numbers, okay? So, today's concept is conversion of rational numbers into decimals. And you know the rational numbers means the numbers which can be expressed in the form of P upon Q, whereas Q must not be equal to 0. Q should not be equal to 0. So this is this form of numbers that is called rational numbers. Okay. So today we are going to learn how to convert rational numbers into decimals. Okay. See, mainly there are two cases conversion of rational numbers into decimals. In that there are two cases. Case one, the remainder becomes 0, and case 2, the remainder never becomes 0. Okay, so let's see the let's deal with the case 1. The remainder becomes 0. See, here I have written 3 examples. We are going to convert these rational numbers into decimal. Let us see what we can observe. See, 5 upon 8. So in this we are going to divide numerator by denominator, 5 divided by 8. Okay, now see, 5 divided by 8, since 5 is less than 8, that's why we divide by 0. 5 zeros are 0, 5 minus 0, 5. Okay, now put a decimal point and take 0 after remainder. Okay, so now we have 50 divided by 8. What? 8 6 are 48. Then 50 minus 48, 2 remain. Again, take 0. Okay, so we have now 20 divided by 8. 20 divided by 8, that is 8 2s are 16. 20 minus 16 is 4. Remainder we have 4. Again take 0 of the remainder. We have now 40. 40 divided by 8. 8 5s are 40. 8 5s are 40. Okay. And 40 minus 40, 0. See, in this division, when we converted this rational number into decimal, in this process, in this division, we have got the remainder 0. Okay, that means the quotient is 0.625. Here the decimal places are in. Okay, let us see second example. 3 upon 4, that is 3 divided by 4. So 4 zeros are 0, 3 minus 0, 3, remainder is 3. Now take decimal point in the quotient and add 1 0 after the remainder. We have now 30. 30 divided by 4, 4 7s are 28. 30 minus 28, 2, correct? Remainder 2. Again take 0, 20, 20 divided by 4, 4 5s are 20. 20 minus 20 is 0. See, in this division also we have got remainder 0 at the end. That means this division has come to the end here. One more example. 1 upon 2, that is 1 divided by 2. Same, 1 divided by 2, since 1 is smaller than 2, that's why take quotient 0. So 2 zeros are 0. 1 minus 0, 1. 1 remain. After that, take decimal point in the quotient. Add 1 0 after the remainder. Understood? Since we have taken a decimal point, we can add 1 0 after the remainder. Now see, here we have 10 divided by 2. 2 5s are 10. Finish. So now if you observe these 3 examples, here we have got quotient 0.625, quotient 0.7, quotient 0.5, and remainder. In all these 3 examples, we have got remainder 0. Understood? So, In this case, this type of case, when we have we get remainder 0 while converting the rational numbers into decimal, when we get remainder 0, that in that case we say that decimal expansion as a terminating is what this expansion is. This here in the quotient, the decimal places have come to the end. After that there will be no decimal places. Here there are 3 decimal places, here there are 2 decimal places, here 1 decimal place, and they have come to the end. There will be no more decimal places because since we have one remainder here, 0. So this type of expansion or this type of conversion of the rational number into decimal is called terminating. What? Terminating. Terminating, meaning of terminating is ending. Okay, end. Okay, terminating expansion of the rational decimal. Now see, second case, the remainder never becomes 0. So when we will convert these rational numbers into decimal, we will observe that the remainders are not getting 0. What happens? Let's see. 10 divided by 3. That is 10 upon 3. So 10 divided by 3. 10 divided by 3, 3 threes are 9, correct? 10 minus 9 remain 1. Remainder is 1, which is smaller than 3. So we can put decimal point and take 1 0. Again we have 10 here. 3 threes are 9. 10 minus 9, again 1. Again we can put 1 0. We can 10 divided by 3. 3 threes are 9. 10 minus 9, again we have got remainder 1. We can add 1 0. 3 threes are 9. So see here, this process is going to be continue and it is not going to terminate. It is not going to terminate. It is continue for uncertain states. Okay? See the question, we have got 3.333 and this is going to continue. That's why you can write here dots. Okay? The meaning of this is this 3333, it will continue for uncertain steps, uncertain times, okay, infinite times. See this, 14 upon 11, that is 14 divided by 11. 11 ones are 11, 14 minus 11 remain 3. Now put decimal point here and take 1, 0, 30. 11 twos are 22. 30 minus 22, 8, 8, 0 here, 80 divided by 11, 11, 7 plus 77, 80 minus 7, 77, 3 again, okay, then add 1, 0 after 3, 30 divided by 11, 11, 2's are 22, 30 upon minus 22, 8. Again, add 0 after 8. We have 80 now. 80 divided by 11. 11, 7, 77. Again, we have remainder 3. See, in the first stage, we had remainder 3. Second stage, we had remainder 8. Again, third stage, we had remainder 3. And again, fourth stage, we have remainder 8. Again, fifth stage, we have remainder 3. So, see. Remainders are repeating. Here 3, again here 3, again here 3. Here 8, again here 8. And this process is going to be continued. In the quotient, see here 1.2727. So, what will be after this? 2727. And it is going to be continued for uncertain or infinite places. Understood? Here in these examples, in this division process, you will never get remainder 0. Okay, means this expansion is never going to be terminated. So it is called non-terminating. It is non-terminating. Non-terminating. But see here, see in the quotient, 3.333. So here after the decimal point, the digit 3 is repeating, right? The digit 3 is repeating again and again. So this pattern is going to be continued in infinite places. That's why what we can say, in short, we can write bar over this 3. So meaning of this is 3 is repeating. Okay, so block of this digit 3 is repeating for infinite steps. Here see which block of the digits is repeating? 2 7 2 7 2 7 2 7. That's why here we can put bar over 1.27, because 2 7 is repeating. Block of the digits 2 and 7 will repeat for infinite places. Understood? Okay, so this is called when certain block of the digits, certain group of the digits repeat. So this type of expansion is called recurring or repeating. Okay, recurring. Okay, so this expansion or decimal expansion can be said as non-terminating recurring. Understood? You can do this example, you will get same result. Not terminating recurring. Here you will not ever get remainder 0. As we have got in this case, here you will never get remainder 0. The decimal places in the portion will repeat, recurring. Okay? That's why it is called non terminating recurring decimal expansion. Understood? So these two cases we have seen in the conversion of rational numbers into decimals. Okay? So we can say that, or we can conclude that in the decimal expansion of the rational numbers, there are only two choices. Whether the first choice is either its decimal expansion is terminating or non-terminating recurring. There are only two choices, either its decimal expansion is terminating or non-terminating recurring. Okay? Or moreover, we can say that the numbers whose decimal expansion is terminating or non-terminating recurring, such numbers are called rational numbers. Okay, or such numbers can be rational numbers. Understood? So write down this in your notebook and let's see more examples on this conversion of rational numbers. Let us solve some examples based on this concept. See question, write the following in decimal form and say what kind of decimal expansion each has. Okay, so these are rational number, let's convert them into decimal form. Okay, and let's see what kind of decimal expansion they have. See first, 36 upon 100, that is 36 divided by 100. Okay, so 36 divided by 100, since 36 is smaller than 100, that's why we will divide, we will say table of 100 is 0, that is 100 zeros are 0, 36 minus 0, 36 is the remainder. Okay. Now, to divide further, we need to take decimal point in the quotient, and that's why we can put 1 0. So 36 became 360, 360 divided by 100, 100, 3s are 300, correct? 360 minus 300, what we are getting? 60. Again put 10, became 600, and 100 6s are 600. Here remainder 600 minus 600, we have got here remainder 0. That means 36 upon 100 is equal to 0.36. And since we have got here remainder 0, that means which kind of decimal expansion it is? Terminating or non-terminating recurring? It's a terminating expansion. Okay, so it is terminating. Okay, terminating expansion. Okay, let's solve next. 1 upon 11, that is 1 divided by 11. 1 divided by 11, 11 zeros are 0, since 1 is smaller than 11, that's why. So 1 minus 0, 1. Okay, take decimal point here, we can take 0 after 1. Again, here there is 10, that's why. Okay, so again it has 10 divided by 11. So again 10 is smaller than 11, that's why 0 is on. Okay, 10 minus 0, 10 again. So after the after 10, we can put here 1 0. Now we have 100 divided by 11. 100 divided by 11. 11, 9s are 99. 100 minus 99, 1. Take 1 0. Again we have 10, 10 divided by 11, 11 zeros are 0, 10 minus 0, 10, put 1 0 after 10, it's 100 now, 100 divided by 11, 9, 11 9 is 99, so 100 minus 99, 1 again. So in this division process, you are never going to get remainder 0, this pattern is going to be continued. Okay, so yes, here we have got remainder 1, then 10, again 1, again 10. This process is going to continue. And in the quotient, we have 0.0909, 0909. This pattern will be continued. Okay, so here which two digits are repeating after in the decimal places? Which block of which two digits is repeating? 09. Understood? 0909. Okay, so the decimal form of 1 upon 11 is 0.0909 dot dot dot, that's why you can write in this way also 0.09 and bar code 09. Since block of the digit 0909 is repeating, that's why we have put bar over 09, and meaning of this bar is 09 is repeating, recurring. Okay, so this expansion, the expansion of this rational number is not terminating, recurring decimal expansion. Okay, so right here it has non terminating recurring decimal expansion. Okay, complete this. It has non-terminating recurring decimal expansion. Okay, it has. Next, 4 integer 1 upon 8. So, since this is mixed fraction, first let's convert it into improper fraction. 8 fours are 32 plus 1, 33 upon 8. So, 33 upon 8. 33 divided by 8. Let's see what happens. 33 divided by 8. 8 4s are 32, correct? Remain 1. Here we have got remainder 1. Now, to continue the division process, we need to take decimal point in the quotient. So, okay, so that we can add 1 0 after the remainder. Now we have 10, 10 divided by 8. 8 1s are 8. 10 minus 8, 2. Again, remainder is 2. Put 1 0 after 2. We have now 20, 20 divided by 8, 8 2's are 16, 20 minus 16, 4, remainder is 4, we can put 1 0 after 4, we have 40 now, 40 divided by 8, 8 5's are 40, so 40 minus 40 is 0, correct? And since we have got remainder 0, this expansion has come to the end here, that's why the quotient is 4.125. It will not continue. It has terminated here. Okay, that's why the decimal expansion of 4 integer 1 by 8 is 4.125. 1, 2, 5, and as the decimal expansion has come to the end, that's why we can say that it has terminating decimal expansion. Okay. Next, 3/30. That is 3/30. 3/13 here. We need to take 0, 13 zeros are 0, 3 minus 0, 3, take decimal point, add 1 0 after the remainder, 30 divided by 13, 13 2s are 26, 30 minus 26 what we get, 4, right? Now see, add 1 0 after 4, we have 40 now, 40 divided by 13, 13 3s are 39. 40 minus 39, 1. Take 1 0. We have 10 now. 10 divided by 13. Again, 10 is smaller than 13, that's why 0 is up. 10 minus 0, 10 again. Add 1 0. We have 100 now. 100 divided by 13. 13, 7s are 91. 100 minus 91. 9. Okay. Add 1 0. 90. Okay. Now 13. 13 6 are 78. 90 minus 78. 12. Add 1 0. 13 9s are. It's going to be lengthy. 13 9s are 117. We have now 3. Okay, now see, here in the first state we had got remainder 3, and after that again we have got remainder 3 here. Let us see, 13, correct? 13 2s are 26. This 13 writing here, then 13 2s are 26. So 30 minus 26 again 4. Again this process. Here as we have got here 4 remainder, same we have got again. So here it will become 40, 30, 3s are 39. Again 1, 0, 10, 10 divided by 13, 0s are again 10. Okay, so this process is going to be continued in the continued for infinite steps. Understood, this is not going to end. It is not terminating. Getting? That's why see number 0.230769. This is one block of the digit. After this block, again 230769. This will repeat again. So here, which block of the digit is repeating? 230769. Okay, that's why what we can see. 3/13 has the decimal expansion 0.230769 bar over it, because these 6 digits are repeating in this expansion, decimal expansion. After decimal point 230769, the block of these 6 digits will repeat, recur. Okay, that's why we have put bar over it, and that's why it has non-terminating. It is not going to end. That's why non-terminating recurring decimal expansion. Recurring decimal expansion. Okay. Understood. Now see, in these examples, here see, this is non-terminating recurring. Again, this is non-terminating and recurring. So in this non-terminating and recurring decimal expansion, see, the digits, the block of digits which recur or repeat, it is called period. It is called period of the expansion. So here 09 is repeating, that's why period of this expansion is 09. 09 is period of this expansion. You can write here 09. And if we want the length of the period, that means in this period how many digits are there? 2 digits. That's why length of this period is 2. Here period is 230769, because these digits are repeating. Okay, these digits are repeating, 230769. That's why period is 230769, and length is number of digits in that period or block, 1 2 3 4 5 6. So here length of this period is 6. If in the question, if it is asked write period and length, then you can write the digits which are recurring, it is period. Okay, so 230769, it is the period of this expansion, and length of this period means in that period how many digits are there, that is length of that period. Okay, so here 6 digits are there, that's why length is 6. Okay, so I hope you have understood this. You can now while converting rational numbers into decimal, you can now segregate or differentiate the two cases when remainder is 0 and remainder is not getting 0. Never, remainder is never 0. That is terminating decimal expansion and not terminating recurring decimal expansion. Okay. And as I told you, the numbers which have terminating and non-terminating recurring decimal expansion, such numbers are said to be rational numbers, or such numbers can be rational numbers. Or in another way, another language, we can say that rational number has terminating and non-terminating recurring decimal expansions. Understood? There is third one case also, but it is not for rational number, it is for irrational numbers. And what is that? What is that decimal expansion? Here we are seeing terminating decimal expansion and non-terminating recurring decimal expansion. There is one third one case in that we will get non-terminating, non-recurring decimal expansion. Means here, as this block of digits are repeating after certain steps, block of digits is repeating. In third case, it will not repeat. We will not get any proper pattern of the decimal places. That is non-recurring, non-repeating, non-terminating, non-repeating. So what kind of numbers they are, that we are going to see in the another our next concept, that is irrational numbers. You will see that afterwards. Okay, so if you have any doubt in this concept, you can ask me. So thank you for today and have a nice day.